Welcome to another episode of TK's Two Cents. Today, we're going to talk about embracing the journey and enjoying the discovery. Or I think I got that backwards. We're going to talk about embracing discovery and enjoying the journey. Let's dive right in. Tweet number one, we need to rebrand our concept of being wrong. When we discover that we're wrong about something, that discovery leads to more possibilities. To be on the side of facts is to be on the side of freedom. We should never be ashamed when new information enlightens our thinking. There's a story of a guy who went to a flea market and he saw this rare Persian rug. And he goes up to the seller and he says, "How much for that rug?" The seller says, "Oh, that's my prized jewel, $99 for that. Very expensive." And the buyer gives him a $100 bill and he says, "I'll take it." Just as he walks off, another man walks up to the seller and said, "Wow, you really gave that guy a steal. That rug is worth at least thousands of dollars." And the seller, looking confused, says, "You mean there are numbers higher than 99? I know. That story's not realistic, right? Surely there are no people who think 99 is the highest number. Well, I'll leave that up for debate. I won't argue with you on that. But what I will say is that even if that story is unrealistic at the level of particulars, it is very realistic at the level of archetypes and abstractions, because all of us know what it is like to be in a situation where we sell ourselves short because we lacked information or insight about what our real possibilities were. I remember when I was in college, I worked this job. It was like my first job. I hadn't had a lot of jobs, and I remember they offered me a certain amount of pay and I thought it was a lot of money and I was so excited about it. And I said, yes. And I worked very hard at that job. I became a very valuable employee, had great relationships with all of my managers. And they hired someone after me, maybe about a year after I started. And I was the person training this person. This person was decent at their job, but whenever they had problems or challenges, you know, I was the one to really either do their job for them or coach them up. And I remember this person, they had a lower title than me and everything. And I remember talking with them about how much they make, and they told me how much they made, and it was so much more than me. And I remember being so mad about it. I was so upset. We've all had experiences like that, right? But you only know what you know. I didn't know what I could ask for. I didn't know what I was worth. And because I didn't know what I was worth, I wasn't able to experience the full range of possibilities that were available to me. But yeah, TK, we shouldn't have to live in a world like that, right? We should live in a world where people take care of you, where people do right by you, even if you don't know what questions to ask and so on. Well, look, we can talk all day about the kind of world that we should live in, but I like to be prepared for the kind of world I actually have. And the kind of world I actually have is one where you will suffer unnecessarily if you don't possess the knowledge you need to have. That's why there's this awesome verse in the Bible that says, "My people perish for a lack of knowledge." Jesus said the words, "Ye shall know the truth, and the truth will make you free." But knowledge is a little bit like going to heaven. You ever heard that saying about going to heaven? The saying is, everybody wants to go to heaven, but no one is willing to die to get there. Well, everyone wants the benefits and the value of knowledge, but few of us are willing to pay the price of being wrong. The very concept of learning presupposes that you are wrong about something right now. Think about it. It's very simple. Either you believe you know everything, or you believe that you have something to learn. If you believe you know everything, well, you're wrong. You've got a bigger problem than what I'm talking about here. But if you believe that you have something to learn, then that means you believe that you're wrong about something right now. But you don't know that you're wrong because you think that you're right. So whatever it is you're wrong about, it's not showing up on your radar as something that you need to correct. It's showing up on your radar as the way it is. You are right now experiencing all of your erroneous beliefs as if it's just the way the world works. But one day you're going to discover something and you're going to say, "Oh my gosh, I was so wrong about that." Think back to 5 years ago. This is how you're going to feel 5 years from now. When you look at yourself 5 years ago, you probably can say, "Oh my gosh, I thought life was like this. I thought things worked that way. Wow, I really have evolved a lot. I really have matured a lot, right? You're probably going to be the same thing 5 years from now. And so being wrong is a really valuable thing because, first of all, it's human to err, but recognizing your error is a really valuable thing, because if you don't recognize your error, then what that means is you're going to persist down a path with self-destructive thinking. You are going to be out of alignment with reality, and you're going to be moving confidently in a direction that leads to destruction or self-defeat, and that's no good. And so we need to promote a culture where we praise and celebrate people who are willing to admit that they are wrong. But one of the reasons we don't have this is because we tend to look at the truth as a weapon rather than a tool. And so we go into conversations looking at the truth, looking at the rightness of my position as something that I am to use to beat other people upside the head, something that I'm to use to slam dunk on people. Ha ha ha, I exposed your error, I win. Well, what did you win? What did you win? A debate, an argument, an ego battle? Nah, there's something better to fight for in life, and that is real, genuine progress. The truth is not a weapon that we use to attack others. The truth is a tool that we use to lift ourselves up, lift other people up, and make the world around us a freer place. And I get that there are people who are enemies of the truth. I totally get that. But the way that we deal with those people and the challenges of life is by letting go of that temptation to demonize the experience of being wrong. The more we feel the need to mock people and goad people and never let them live it down when they admit that they are wrong about something, the harder we make it for ourselves and others to embrace the beauty of acknowledging that they are wrong. And on the flip side, not just in terms of how you react to other people, but in terms of how you preach the things that you believe to be true. I remember hearing Malcolm X say, and this is a paraphrase, that never forget when you are teaching other people with great confidence that there was a time when you had to learn the very things that you now confidently teach. Have a little empathy for the people that are struggling to understand or accept the things that you know. You can have strong beliefs, you can have strong convictions, but teach with conviction, not with condemnation. That's all I have to say for the day. Those are TK's two cents. Oh, wait a minute. I'm ending early. I'm ending early. I got going on that one so much that I thought that I gave two tweets. I got to give you another tweet. I owe you folks another tweet. It's called TK's two cents, not TK's penny for your thoughts. So let's go to tweet number two. See, you got to embrace the detection of error. I just messed up. That was beautiful. I didn't even plan that. That's how you got to do it. Got to have a sense of humor about yourself. You can't run from it. I just made a mistake. I was wrong. I thought I did one when it was actually two. So perfect in timing. All right, tweet number two. You don't need to be where you want to be. You just need to be in the process of growing in that direction. I want you to imagine that you're taking a long road trip, a road trip similar to what I took years ago when I first moved to LA. I don't live there now, but when I first moved there, I took a road trip from Chicago to LA, which is a little more than 2,000 miles. Imagine that's what you're doing. You're driving from Chicago to LA. For the overwhelming majority of your trip, you are going to be somewhere other than LA. LA is the destination. That's the place that you're trying to go. But for 90% of the ride, you're going to be not in LA. And you won't be in LA until maybe like the last 45 minutes to an hour of your ride. So if you define success solely in terms of being in LA, being in my destination, then you're going to feel like a failure along the way and have a mostly miserable time. So what do you need to do? Well, you want to remain loyal to your concept of a desired destination, but you also want to expand your understanding of success a little bit and include something else, namely progress, the experience of progress. For the majority of your trip, you are somewhere other than the desired destination, but it is also true that when you look back, you are not where you used to be. And that is something that is so critical to keep in mind in life. We all have places that we want to go. We all have directions in which we want to grow. And in life, we spend the majority of our time being something other than the ideal self that we want to be, having something less than the ideal version of what we want to have, because we are always in motion. We are always in process. Life is not a static condition. It is a dynamic, ongoing experience. And most of our time is spent in some space other than the destination. So if you only define success in terms of getting there, you'll spend most of your time being miserable because most of your time is somewhere other than there. So you got to think about life in terms of progress. Am I growing in the right direction? And if you're growing in the right direction, that's all you need to do, because that's where the joy is. That's really where the life is. The goals, the destinations, those are just meaningful excuses for flowing the energy of life. But what life is really about is participating in the creative process and discovering interesting things about ourselves along the way. Keep that in mind the next time you choose to go after something. You may not be where you want to go, but are you committed to the process of growing in the space that you find yourself in now? If the answer to that question is yes, that's all you need. Now, that is TK's Two Cents for the day. Cheers to embracing discovery and enjoying the journey. Don't hesitate to let me know in the comments if you have any questions for me. If there are any future conversations you'd like to see me have, please hit the like button. Please hit the subscribe button. And please share this with a family member or friend or anyone that you think might benefit from these riffs. Cheers, everybody. Have a fantastic week.